Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at the Blackmagic camera app for the iPhone, and it's a free app you can download, and it's going to give you all of the great controls you know from your Blackmagic cameras into what now will be a truly pocket cinema camera. So let's have a look at the menu and just basically how the app works. So let's just do that. So let's, I have out of frame here, and of course you're going to see my camera. I have here out of frame my subject here, and here you have the overall look for the camera. You can go up here in the top and just tap the button. So you want to shoot something in something else than 24 frames, you can do that. And then you can change that here just by swiping up and down. I'll be at 24. And then we have the shutter, which is one of, want to, that to be one out of a 50th. And then of course we have controls like the ISO, and we can bump the ISO up to, let's say 800 or something. Let's say something like that looks decent. And then of course, if we click here up in the top, we can go into the white balance. And right now we can change the different settings. If we want to, you can also use the auto just by pushing out here, and then it's just going to auto white balance everything. But if you don't want to do that, you can click that off, and then you can change the different settings. So it'll have the look you want. I think I want this, so that's pretty good. Also, if we look at the screen, we can see we have our histogram here. We have a dedicated audio metering, so we can click the audio metering and you can change the gain controls if you had a microphone on. So now I'm just using the built-in microphone from the iPhone, and that's what we're having here. We have a bunch of settings. Also, what is super cool about the app is actually if you it can be a bit troublesome holding your camera like this when shooting. However, if we just turn it around like that, it's going to flip everything around, and we're still going to shoot that wide aspect ratio, which is most common if you're not doing like Instagram, TikTok or something, but if you're doing content that you want to be seen on a screen. So pretty cool. And also all of the things in the menu are now down here. So we have a couple of cool things. Let's try this one. If we push here, we can actually go in and we can zoom in our footage here, or we can do a digital zoom at least, which is kind of cool. We can also see the lens. I'm on the 26 millimeter lens. I can go to the 13 millimeter, and now I have a wider view. And of course I can also use the front camera like I'm doing right now, but you know, the quality of the front camera isn't that great. So I'll just go to the 26 mil lens again. And also we have this button right here, which is actually stabilization. So we have either off, so we can see here how that looks. It's going to be all jittery. Then we can go to standard. And I'm again, just moving the camera. We can go to cinematic. And then we can see it's a little more pleasing for the eye. And then to the extreme, where it's actually kind of just moving in and then slowing down. It's pretty cool. So I'll keep that on cinematic. Also, we of course can go in and change the exposure and stuff like that, as you can see right here. Also, we have the autofocus button. We can also just hold or tap to focus, which we are doing right now. Also, one of the things I think is super great about the menu in the cinema camera or in the pocket camera or in all the Blackmagic cameras, the menus, is that it's so intuitive. So if you just click here, we have all of these different things. We can actually apply a LUT. So now it's on off. I don't think there is a LUT actually in yet, because you can kind of put that in. Then we have our false colors are actually here, so we can use that to make a better looking image, which is super cool. We also have our guidelines, and that's super nice if we want to keep everything in our composition in the right place. We also have, of course, the again, the aspect ratio thing, so we can kind of make that so we have these guidelines so we know how to frame our shot if we're doing widescreen bars on our end product. Again, super cool. Also, we have all of the grid functions, so we can put in like a, we have a grid, we have a cross and a dot. We can actually just turn them off. So we have a dot, so that is the center of our shot if we want to keep that. Also, we can put in a cross, so we can kind of use that if we are tracking our subject. And then, of course, we have the rule of thirds here, so we can do a pretty nice composition where we put the object at the right spot in our shot. Super, super cool. And of course, we also have the false colors, which are right here, so we can make sure that everything we want is in focus. Pretty cool. Lots of great things in the app. Also, if we want to go in and change the recording format, we actually can. So we're just going to push the settings button. And here we have the codecs up in the top. And we can just click here and we can change that into ProRes HQ or ProRes 444. There's a lot of ProRes, also proxy. But for now, I'm just going to leave it as it is because the file size are going to be drastically bigger on the phone. And also we have a media tab here. And this is where it's going to store all our clips. And there is actually a lot of things going on about the Blackmagic cloud storage thing. I'm not looking so much into that yet, but that's really interesting compared to that you can actually make proxies from your phone and it can upload that directly up to DaVinci Resolve and really, really make your workflow when using DaVinci Resolve way faster than you normally would. So, I'm going to play around a little more with the camera app. It's pretty fun. And maybe I'll do a follow-up video where I try to shoot a video using the app on the phone. And let's see how that's going to work all out. But for now, the app is free and it is available on the App Store for the iPhone. So anyway, I do hope you found this little overview interesting. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.